Hello everyone. I wish a very pleasant good afternoon to everyone. I thought let's share my views with all the parents and students about how to use, you know, the potential energy which is inside us. So I would like to start with you know, the human mind. You all know that we all people are known as known by our mind. If somebody recognizes you today, it is by your mind only. And this mind is so important, it's so important that without this we cannot imagine anything. But still, most of us are not using the some portion of the mind, which if we use that, we can do anything, we can do wonder in our life. So as per most of the psychologists, scientists, they have mentioned that there are the three parts of the mind, or you can say three concepts about the mind. The one is called id, second is called ego, and third is called superego. Let me tell you in a brief, because I'm just going to speak for the 15 minutes only. Id mean it is something is a basic. It is in every human being, and you can say that these are the basic instincts. And this is available in every human being. That is called the id. Id is that feeling which sometimes it's very difficult to control it, like hunger, anger, happiness. This all is called id. But apart from it, there's a one more thing that is called second part or second concept of the mind. That is called ego. Ego is kind of a policeman. It's control the id. And then third is called superego. It is like a judge who's very wise, who's full of advice. It will advise you, it will guide you. So we can say in a simple language, there are three parts of the mind. One is called id, second is called ego, and third is called superego. Id is basically your basic instincts, which we generally hide. So people should, we should not show to people. So to control to that aid, ego is working like a policeman. Ego is mean that, oh, somebody can see me, what people will think about me. This kind of feeling is called ego. Normally people say that ego is bad, but let me tell you, ego is not bad. Ego is a good in this conception, because ego control your id. And third is superego. Superego mean that, oh, what people are going to think about me, how it's going to impact if I'll show my id to people, what people will think about me, what will be my future. I'll give a simple example. For example, there is a sweet lying on a plate, and very small child come near to that sweet, and guests are sitting. Without noticing about the people, he pick up the sweet and put into the mouth. Fine. Another person who is standing nearby, he may be of my age, and he also want to eat, but he will not eat before the guest. He will say what the people will say to me if I'll eat more. So that's the ego. The child which is showing, that is id, and ego is controlling me that I should not behave like that. There's one more feeling in me. Oh no, I have to be look good before the people. I should not do this kind of the things which can, you know, defame me, and what the people will think about me, you know, kind of myself. So that is called superego. So this is a general description about the mind, but we'll go for one more part, which is my topic today, is called subconscious mind. Now I am talking to you. This is conscious state of mind. You are listening to me, I am talking to you. This is conscious mind. Fine. Another is subconscious. There are something in my mind, there are a lot of potential, but I'm not using it. Fine. Third is unconscious, which I use very rarely. So now let me tell you about now subconscious. If I say that in a normal talking, in normal day life, we only use 1/10 of our the complete state of mind. Only 1/10. If we come to know about that, what is subconscious, let me tell you, we can make wonder. but only we parent, teachers, sometimes we don't recognize that how to take out the potential from the children. I just want to give a very small example. I remember that my son, a few years back, he was going to kitchen and he asked his mother, "Mother, can I make a cup of tea for you?" So my wife, she refused, "No, he's going to kitchen, he's going to spoil the kitchen, he's a so small and he may get hurt also, how will on the gas?" So many questions she was thinking. But I told him, "No, my dear son, you go and bring a cup of tea for me." When I said you go, he was so confident, he has gone to kitchen, he made a tea. Let me tell you, the tea which he has made, it was the most tasty tea of my life. When I told him, "Well done," you know, he's like that, "Oh my God, I am something now." I have shown him the confidence, he has shown his the potential. So after that, he becomes so confident that he's doing well in life. So small things matter. But normally parent, when they appreciate their child, when he's winning, when he's bringing laurel to family, when he's bringing some, you know, prize to family, we appreciate a lot to the child, that is, he's my son, he's my daughter. But please remember, he's your son and daughter then also when he fails. You must appreciate, no problem. Your participation is more important. Getting first, second, third position is secondary thing. But you participated, that's the most important thing. I'm proud on you, my son, my daughter. Then you see that where the child will go. And in our life, you know, the most of the people who are the good leader, they don't bother about success and failure. They just do their work. And let me tell you, when you do the work the way you want, without taking care of any consequences of it, you will win always. But most of us, we always work with that spirit that we have to win. That's not right. Now in our, if you see the, in the most of the students, after their results, if the results are not good, they become upset because this is our expectation from them. You let them feel, let them realize that life is not always success. Sometimes it's failure also. We need to accept the failures. We should be ready to accept, you know, if we say something no to our children, they should be happy to listen no. It's not that you start fulfilling all the demands. If they say, "Father, I need this thing," you are giving. "Mother, I need this thing," you are giving. But once you said I know, the child is going to get annoyed and upset. If 10 times he says, you know, you're giving, and one time you can say no also. Make them realize that no is also important. Failure is also important. If you really want to do something in your life, we have to be, you know, ready to accept that sometime failure will come and we will treat it equally. Otherwise, what will happen? The child is going to develop a system called, in psychology, this is known as defense mechanism. I remember that there was a student in my school around 20 years back when I was teaching, my subject was psychology, and that child used to come late to the class. You know, whenever he was coming, the all kids were sitting like this, and whenever he was coming, "Sir, may I come in?" So we all used to turn toward him like this, whole class. And you know why he was doing? He was seeking some attention. Later on I come to know that no one loves him. So this is the parents. When we don't love child, he will become different. He will become abnormal. We need to love our children. We need to show that you are everything to us. You are the best. Otherwise, they are going to develop their self-defense mechanism. You know what happened? Sometimes this kind of defense mechanism is a very harmful. Sometimes I have seen the children, they break blackboard, they make damage to take attention from the people because we are not giving them attention. Maybe nowadays husband and wife, they both are working, but please, we need to see that we must have some time for our children. Otherwise they're going to develop so many, you know, defense mechanism which in the long run will harm them. They will not be a good personality. Second, I want to share with you one more thing that as a parent we are doing. We are also doing a kind of defense mechanism. The most of the parents is called displacement. in human psychology, this is known as a displacement. What we are doing, if I'm not happy, suppose somebody rebuked me, somebody scolded me, and I'm not happy, so I'm emotionally not good. So what I will do, I will displace my emotion to make myself easy to that place where people accept me, my family. So I will be showing my anger to my family, so they will be the victim. So this kind of displacement is not good. Then it's going to form a vicious circle. My family will not happy, my children will not happy, whom they will meet, they will also displace their anger, that kind of emotion to others, and it's going to form a vicious circle. So we need to be very, very careful. We must need to show the confidence among our children. I want to tell you the one last line. After that I will give a pause to my words. There was a person, he was known as a balloon seller. He was selling balloons to attract children, so that children will come and his business will work more. The balloon were gaseous balloon filled with the hydrogen gas. Hydrogen being a light gas, the balloons fly in the air. So many children were standing near to him. One of the boy, he was watching him, you know, very carefully, and he asked, "Gentlemen, this balloon of red color will fly with the same height as compared to yellow, green, blue, black?" So the balloon seller was surprised of why he's asking this. Then he realized that what he wants to ask. He said that the color of the balloon is, that's not matters. The things which take the balloon up, that is called your gas inside it. So same way in our life, it's hardly matter either our children are physically strong or not. Fine. The thing which matter is the confidence. Confidence they take them up. Confidence is only can take them up. So we need to show the confidence among children. Let me tell you, the day we show the confidence among our children, they are going to be the best person on this planet. We need to create that. Thank you so much for listening to me. Given your time to me, thank you so much. I wish a good day to everyone. Thank you so much.